You see, my husband was terribly fond of St. Bridget. And we used to go up the Fahord at 6 in the morning and pray, and we used to meet the bishop. We'd have devotions in the evening and I'd bake the crosses for them, like cut the oats, and he'd trash them, and he'd go into the garage. And you see, my husband was sick a lot, he had cancer. And we used to put the shave of oats in the garage, and he'd tease them down to the first knot. And then he'd take the oats off it. And that's where he used to start to make the crosses with. But there was a lot of people used to make the three-armed one. I only stuck to the one make.
Do you give your crosses away as gifts?
Oh, yeah, I'd give somebody a present of a cross. And when anyone would be getting married, when I used to make the crosses behind the bar instead of serving, like, I'd be talking and making the crosses. Because that time you could go out to the field and get a shave of oats or rushes. It was rushes we did them then, and I used to make them. And then this is President McLeish. Their country women went and they asked me would I make a cross for them. And the Pope has one, and a man from Knock has one when he was building the airport. Two men came in from my man, and I suppose maybe they were used to call to see him. My mother, she was from the north, you see. And he called in and he says, I want to know who makes the crosses, see that you have all around the place, right? I mean, stones and everywhere. And she said, the daughter. So that's how I got to know him then. I suppose I don't know whether he asked me to make him one, I suppose he did maybe. So then I brought them into the museum. Well, it must have been well on making them then when those small ones you got in. We were down on a tour one day and I decided to go in, and I was an awful lot of looking to see where they were, and I got them and they hardly believed me. They never knew what a museum was until that day when I saw all the old style of skirts and dresses, and all that caught me eye. Always have one in the house where you're safe. Because it prevents fire and anything like that. And get one and put it up in your house. Oh yeah, I gave one to a girl, she got married, and she put the cross at the bottom of her stairs. And she was telling me that her house went on fire one day, and the cross fell down, wasn't even touched. The house was saved, like it only went. And then another one that said that the cross only went, it only burned so far and stopped. Come to the cross. There's a couple of cases, and then there was another man, he used to drive the petrol around the country, and I gave him one for his lorry, and he met me one day and he told me that cross saved my life. He had an accident and he was found on the road and the cross across his forehead. We were there, see, we'd have a procession and devotions every year, and it was beside us. And that was St. Bridget's. You'd have to go under the banner when you were starting off the procession, you see. It'd be across the road. You see, there was flags out and banners out and everything that time. Oh, yeah, you'd gather about this four or six, I don't know which was, to be called Bridget, and they'd sit on the carriage, like a big cart, like a dray, like what the brewery men used to have, one of them. Really, you'd be sitting on it, and they'd be round it, and they'd be carried up the ford. Because we used to be rushing to get a spin home. It was always in the chapel, wasn't it? It was always under the altar in the chapel, the relic of St. Bridget, and then they took it out. Or anything special on, the relic would be out. If there was an Avino on, the relic would be out every night. It would be us on display, and then everybody would be blessed with the relic. It was at the church. We start with one. And you put one over one to start. And you turn it to the left. And you put another one. And you put it over the one you're after doing. And you keep going round again, it doesn't matter what thickness it is now. You put it down over there. And you seal it again. Another one. That's three. Trying to get the big ones put in order. And round, you keep on round now. If they're thick ones, you squeeze them in. that. Put another one over here. And you put another one over here. And you keep going around now till you get the amount that you're looking for. You must put it in behind the one you're doing here. In there. You must put it in there to catch that one. And then in here, catch this one. And if I let go now, the whole thing would all fall apart before I got this one in. You know what I mean? It seals it. And then you keep pushing them all in there, and there you have seven each side. Seven, 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 seven. And four sevens is 28. And there's 28 days in February. And that's what the cross, seven each side you do. And one and 29 leap year.